So in the globe, we're bringing out all the teams that have competed, the eight teams who have been involved in the globe tournament. Austria, who faced up against Australia earlier on pitch three. And Austria take their round of applause for their efforts throughout the week. And there are a few Austrians in the crowd cheering on their team. Australia.
See the injured goalkeeper, Shannon Necht. There, I had a chat with him yesterday back at camp. And he's got an incredible bruise all down his arm that's almost mottled into a sort of scaly pattern. It's a terrible injury to his arm early in the tournament.
Well, and also Australia have been getting involved very heavily in some of the great work that's been going on just down the street from here at the Glasgow Gallery of Modern Art, and dedicating some nice pieces there. The Swiss coming on, Rudi Kalin, who really has been, as we mentioned, some of the characters. The Swiss goalkeeper, Rudi. And of course, the Swiss, who scored, as far as I'm aware and to my knowledge, the only headed goal so far.
There was, in fact, another. There have been two headed goals that I've seen on pitch one. So hard to do. Brilliant by them to get that ball in the back of the net, obviously off a header. We saw a great rebound as well yesterday. So great effort by them. But here come yet last year's hosts, the Dutch.
And the Dutch, who managed to see off Switzerland to finish fifth in the globe competition. And then you saw them here on pitch one just before the final. The Ivory Coast, who had plenty of outside factors to deal with in this tournament. A team growing in confidence as the tournament went on, and met up with the United States, in which was one of the most friendly games between two competitive nations. The United States coming on, and they taking the bronze position in this Globe Cup, finishing third overall after that excellent game that they put in against the Ivory Coast, in particular with their number seven. Well, the runners-up in the Globe Cup, Sweden, who got all the way to the final. Their big moment coming in their semi-final when they saw off the Ivory Coast.
But just wait for this. Here come the winners. It's a little quiet build-up.
Well, what a performance they put on in that final and throughout the week. The Cambodians absolutely loving life right now.
A small team in stature, a small team in numbers. Absolutely fabulous by them. And little Manea Chan holding that flag. He's been an inspiration. He's been a talisman. They have deserved nothing less than a trophy, the Cambodians.
Looks like they managed to pick up a young Scottish mascot as well, obviously somebody who has taken the Cambodian side to his heart. And the referees doing a fine job as well. We did have that controversial moment in the final. It did not have an impact on the outcome. Cambodia with that shot off the underside of the bar. Did it cross? Did it not? Well, we'll leave that one up to you. One of the favourite characters of this entire tournament, Manea Chan, the Cambodian captain and number nine, accepts the Globe Cup, and Cambodia celebrate their performance at the Homeless World Cup 2016, and they are absolutely delighted.
It's amazing to see the range of teams and nations that are in this tournament from all different corners of the world.
Well, congratulations to all eight teams involved in the Globe competition. We thank them for the entertainment they have given us throughout the week. But most of all, congratulations to Cambodia, winners of the Globe Cup.